By January 1945, the German position on the Eastern Front was precarious at best. It was famously described as a house of cards by General Heinz Guderian, who warned that if broken at any point, the entire front would collapse. The German army was still reeling from the devastating effects of Operation Bagration in the summer of 1944, which was by far its worst and most materially impactful defeat of the war. The offensive in Ukraine and Belarus had brought the Red Army to the River Vistula in Poland and destroyed Army Group Center, which lost 400,000 men in the fighting. Along the Vistula, Soviet forces remained largely static for several months, while men and material were built up in several bridgeheads for a final offensive that would take them to Berlin. On January 12, 1945, the Vistula-Oder offensive was launched. German intelligence estimated their forces were outnumbered by about 10 to 1 in infantry, 7 to 1 in tanks and 20 to 1 in artillery. Despite protests from some generals, Hitler, who dismissed the estimations of Soviet strength as nonsense, had also recently transferred significant forces to Hungary, whose oil fields were Germany's last remaining source of fuel. German defences proved hopelessly inadequate to resist the Soviet juggernaut, and by the end of January, Soviet forces had torn an enormous hole in the front line and reached the Oder, less than 70 kilometres from the German capital. With the German position now critical, Operation Solstice or Sonnenwende, also later known as the Stargard tank battle, was developed as a limited offensive to blunt the Red Army's advance. The operation was originally envisioned as a major offensive, similar to the Ardennes offensive that had caught Allied armies in the West by surprise in December. General Heinz Guderian attempted to convince Hitler to transfer forces from other fronts and postpone another offensive planned in Hungary for an ambitious Herculean effort to turn Soviet forces away from the gates of Berlin. He envisioned that German forces would attack from the north and south in a pincer movement that would cut off, encircle and destroy leading Soviet armies. However, Hitler could not be convinced, and thus Operation Solstice went ahead as a limited offensive to blunt the Soviet advance and ensure the front line along the Oder could be stabilised and reinforced. Over 1,200 tanks were allocated to the operation. This would be one of the last times the German army would be able to concentrate such a large number of armoured forces. Among them were a considerable number of Panther tanks, as well as the Tiger II or King Tiger heavy tank. However, transport proved a considerable problem, meaning many vehicles were not in position by the start of the operation, while ammunition and fuel reserves were critically low. At best, regardless of the success of the offensive, they could only support about 3 days of operation. Operation Solstice was launched in the Pomerania region of East Prussia on February 15th along a 30-mile front. Unlike many other late-war German offensives which enjoyed initial success, it proved a failure almost immediately. An initial attack at Arnswald in West Pomerania had caught the Soviet forces by surprise, the besieged garrison was relieved and the front was pushed back by several kilometres. But as the offensive widened, further attacks faltered and stalled. Although they did destroy a large number of Soviet tanks and guns and recaptured some towns, German forces also sustained heavy losses for what amounted to negligible local gains. They had no effective reserve to commit to the offensive, and at this stage of the war, losses of heavy tanks and experienced crews could not easily be made good. There had also been an unexpected thaw in the weather, and many of the heavy vehicles became bogged down in the mud. On the 17th of February, Soviet General Zhukov committed the 2nd Guards Tank Army to a counterattack, which the German forces were scarcely in a position to resist. And on the night of the 17th, the German commander leading the offensive, the very capable General Walter Wenck, was seriously injured in a car accident. The operation was called off the following day, and several days later, after tough fighting, German forces withdrew from the captured territory. It had been an expensive failure. It had cost a large number of heavy tanks, which Germany could ill afford to lose at this stage of the war. Furthermore, it had considerably impacted on Germany's already critically low fuel reserves. But there was a victory of sorts to be gleaned from the operation. Despite its failure and the fact that Soviet forces were just 70 kilometres from Berlin, the attempted counterstroke was a cause for serious alarm in the Soviet high command. The Kremlin became convinced that the previously envisioned quick strike at Berlin was now out of the question until German forces could be fully cleared from the flanks of the Soviet armies furthest west. This task took several months to complete and claimed hundreds of thousands of lives on both sides and allowed the German army to reinforce its position along the River Oder to protect Berlin. The Battle of Berlin and almost immediately thereafter the war in Europe ended on May 2, 1945, 2 days after Hitler committed suicide in the Führerbunker. Had the Germans not launched Operation Solstice, the Soviet High Command may have continued with its original objective of a lightning strike against the German capital as early as February. Thanks for watching this video. Please like and subscribe if you'd like to see more content. Special thanks to Military 1945 for archive footage. There's a link to their channel below if you'd like to access more of their material.